The former Pro Bowl cornerback for the Kansas City Chiefs and the San Diego Chargers is now a free agent and will be visiting with the Arizona Cardinals and is actually in talks with the New England Patriots. And so when I look at this, I definitely look at Brandon Flowers as a pretty gritty guy. The reason why he actually joined the Chargers, a division rival to the Chiefs, of course, is because he wanted revenge on them because he didn't like the way he was cut from them. Apparently, he signed a big contract 2 years earlier, and then he decided to say, you know, I want to finish my career here. The fact that you guys got rid of me, I want revenge on you. And I think that's definitely something good. And speaking about having grit on your football team, that's why I'm going to start off why the Cards would like them and why they need them. So first things first, he would be a good second cornerback right there. Obviously, when you have Patrick Peterson, you don't need a first cornerback. Even though Brandon Flowers was a first corner at one point, it would definitely be very, very interesting. Also, when you look at him, I think that he's the one player that did really well. The one team he did really well against in the NFC was the Arizona Cardinals. And when you look at Steve Keim's philosophy, or not really Steve Keim's philosophy, in general, just a philosophy in sports is when a player does really well against you, that's the player you want to have back on your team, a player that you want. And I think that could be definitely a reason why motivation, because he's had actually some good games against them in the past when he's played them against Arizona. And when I look at that, I definitely think that's a good kind of sign right there. And I understand with Steve Keim. If you ever saw Arizona Cardinals this season with them, all or nothing, I have a link description. I have a review of that. You could click on that right there if you're interested. But when it came to signing a Red Bryant was a run stuffer. Obviously, he needed a run stuffer, most importantly, but he was a run stuffer that did very well against the Cardinals, so that's why the Cardinals brought him in. That's why it makes sense. Also, he plays in a zone defense. When he played in Kansas City loves playing a cover 3 defense, and I think that could definitely work out well for him. But he could also play man too, because Patrick Peterson can play man very well too. He has a lot of athleticism there. And so, with that, it's a good compliment right there, because if you want a man corner right there, it could definitely be good. So you could put him right there. He has great ball skills. I think that could help too. The Arizona Cardinals defense loves getting interception. He definitely supplies that. And I think also another important part is you could possibly convert him to safety. You actually see me later on the video actually using him as a safety in Madden, where I think that could be helpful because they lost Tony Jefferson last year. Tony Jefferson had a good year with them. He's a good safety. He's not a great one, but a good one. If you could put Brandon Flowers right there, it's a short-term option at safety. I think that could be helpful. I know the Arizona Cardinals might have a couple guys right there. They might sneak in at second corner or safety, but still valuable and still something that could be good. And I think a guy right next to Tyrann Mathieu would help. It's a lot of depth there. He's a gritty guy. And that kind of relates well with Bruce Arians. Just a gritty guy right there. And also, will he be Antonio Cromartie, what he was for them in 2014? No. Antonio Cromartie was a Pro Bowler. He had a very good year in 2014. That was Antonio Cromartie's last great year, or just a good year from him. That was his last year in his prime. But I think Brandon Flowers could be a solid pick for them. Also, I look at that, and I just feel that he has the ball skills that Antonio Cromartie brings. Does he have the speed that Antonio Cromartie has? No. Does he have the size that Antonio Cromartie has? No, but he's good depth right there. And also, that's what I think the Arizona Cardinals secondary was the best when they had that second corner right there. And I think that would be very good. Also, this is my most important thing, grit. He's a gritty guy. When I look at Bruce Arians is a very angry and vulgar man. And sometimes I feel as if the Cardinals players don't really respond to him the way Bruce Arians wants him to. And I just think he needs that grit right there. And I think that the fact that Brandon Flowers is one of these guys that kind of felt kind of angry, that's kind of what you need. You know what I mean? Maybe he's being butthurt over the fact that he was cut by his like football team because it's a business at the end of the day. But at the same time, though, the fact that he wants to have kind of revenge, just kind of this factor out. Oh, he has that anger right there. He has that passion that maybe Bruce Arians wants. And that's where he could get the response for. Now going on to the New England Patriots. I guess they want cornerback depth right there. I think that you could technically push a Cyrus Jones. Cyrus Jones obviously did not have a very good year for the Patriots. He had a very bad year for the Patriots. He had 11 punt returns. 6 of them were fumbles. That's absolutely unexcusable, and I think that would be bad. Also, I'm kind of surprised because they do have Eric Rowe. Eric Rowe is kind of a tall corner. I know Brandon Flowers is 5'9", but when I look at that, Eric Rowe did a good job against Julio Jones in the Super Bowl for what he did, because he held him to 4 receptions, 70 yards. Yet again, they used Julio Jones more as a distraction, but I think that's still depth right there that they do appreciate. Also, when I look at him, I think this is the most important factor of Brandon Flowers, is that he went to Hargreave Military School, and Bill Belichick grew up in a military family. Bill Belichick has a bias to military guys. The reason why Cyrus Jones was his first draft pick in the 2016 draft was simply because I think that his granddad was a part of the military or whatnot, or his father was a part of the military, and he has a military background, military upbringing. That's why Bill Belichick likes him. Also, there's other reasons. They need a return man. He was from Alabama. Bill Belichick is close with the Alabama's head coach, Nick Saban, so that obviously makes a lot of sense there. Also, a lot of significant football players went to this private high school right there. If you look at Muhammad Wilkerson, plays for the New York Jets, very good outside linebacker. Kind of had a down year in 2016, but I think he would be back in action in 2017, back to the elite pass rusher that he was. Ahmad Brooks, middle linebacker for the San Francisco 49ers, good one right here. And then you got Torrey Holt, who I believe Hall of Famer, to be in the Hall of Fame, yet to be in the Hall of Fame, something in that regards. He played there, and not only was he a great player, but also the Patriots had him for a little bit, but only for like a training camp, dead serious. He was older. He was a part of Torrey Holt, was a Rams receiver, part of the greatest show on turf. And when I look at that, I think that you look at that, and that's kind of something that Bill Belichick looked at, because he liked Torrey Holt, went to a military school, brought him in. I think that's why it relates back to Brandon Flowers. Sorry for the pause right there. There's a phone ringing on the bench over there where I'm by. And also, one thing for sure is Brandon Flowers does well against AFC teams that Bill Belichick doesn't like, quote unquote, or a lot of teams that he has a lot of competitive games, because where Brandon Flowers really shines is AFC play. If you look at the Denver Broncos, he does well against them, Indianapolis Colts, Buffalo Bills, New York Jets, San Diego Chargers, or now the Los Angeles Chargers, however you want to call them, Baltimore Ravens. Those are teams that have had good games with the New England Patriots in the past. Well, maybe besides the Bills, but even the Bills have had at least like a couple good games here and there. But those are teams that compete with the New England Patriots. And so that's why he's bringing them in right there. And I look at that and I think that definitely makes sense. I definitely see the need right there. Also, this might seem strange, but this is not the first time Bill Belichick wanted him. And this is definitely a player I would maybe understand more of an Anquan Boldin. I'm foreshadowing right there about Anquan Boldin. He'd be mentioned later in the video. But Anquan Boldin would be feel like a player that Bill Belichick would go after. Kind of a player that was great in his career. That's a guy you go after twice because he's great. Brandon Flowers was just good. He had 21 interceptions in his career. He had 3 sacks. He's a cornerback. He has some decent pass protection. And he made it to 1 Pro Bowl in 2013. So when I look at this, I definitely think that it's definitely interesting to go. This is the second time to go after a player who's just good. But I think there's definitely a reason there. Obviously, the military. Obviously, military background. Obviously, he does well against the AFC. But I think most importantly was I think Bill Belichick wanted to draft him in 2008. And the reason why was in 2007, the Patriots almost went undefeated. They almost had a perfect season. But then the New York Giants spoiled their season and the greatest upsets in sports history, one of the greatest Super Bowls of all time. And I think that he was thinking about drafting him. Obviously, he didn't have a first-round pick, that he was going to be the Asante Samuel replacement, because Asante Samuel left the during that offseason when the NFL draft was going on, where Brandon Flowers participated in it. And I think that was a guy that he was going to look at, because obviously if you like Asante Samuel, if you like an underneath corner with ball skills, that's Asante Samuel, and Brandon Flowers is kind of like that. Also, there's some other links to the teams that I want to bring up that the Arizona Cardinals and New England Patriots have been linked to. 2 players, Anquan Boldin, Darrell Revis. I truly love both these players. Anquan Boldin is a great, tough player. If he goes to Arizona, he brings that greenness, he brings that toughness back to them. Also, it would be a nice reunion right there. And also, he's an outside wide receiver. If they need it, they still run that vertical offense that they did with Kurt Warner back in 2008. So they still would want that. They would love that. Also, Darrell Revis would be an interesting choice for both the Patriots. Obviously, it would be a reunion there. Obviously, very familiarity. Obviously, Revis has had great games against the Patriots, so that's a reason why. Also, one thing for sure about Revis is he's played under Todd Bowles, assisted some Todd Bowles with a defensive corner under Bruce Arians. Player system gets used to it. Darrell Revis struggled under Todd Bowles because he was the number one corner. If you move the number two corner, he has less responsibility, less of a wide receiver to deal with. Obviously, after that speed run, guys, I got to share some links to the videos. Obviously, share the links in the descriptions of articles if you want to read. If you want to see part one and part two of my quarterback battles in the video, those are the links in the descriptions. All right, see you guys.